My dear children, am I audible and visible? We face some tech issue, but I think it's fine now and you were able to hear me and see me. Good evening, my dear children. This is Dr. Vani, and on behalf of Vedanta, I welcome you all to today's session. Good evening. Good, yes, I can see myself right now there. So good evening and welcome to today's super amazing session. This is Biological Classification, lecture number 2. And in today's class, I'm going to be starting with Kingdom Monera. There is going to be a mentee quiz immediately after the class. So before I move ahead, why don't you make a heart and tell me whether all of you can hear and see me loud and clear? I just want to get a heart there. Yes, so I can see Uday, Anurag, Abhinav. Good, 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 good. Pallavi, Ritik, everybody, good, perfect. That means all of you can hear, all of you can see me, and you're all super duper excited for today's amazing class on biological classification. Lecture number 2, Monera. Monera is bacteria. I did share a photograph. How many of you saw that photograph I just shared? Tell me. That obviously was a lichen, and lichens have symbiotic relationships between lichens and cyanobacteria. So obviously you can't see them with the naked eye. Everybody knows that. Bacteria cannot be seen with the naked eye. But that is a symbiotic relationship. So if you take lichens and you soak them in water for some time and then you culture the bacteria and put it under a microscope, you will be able to see that. Correct, everybody? Sat Sri Akal, Jasmeet, how are you? Everybody, chalo. Shuru karte hain, aaj bahut extra information wala class hai. So I want you to sit with your papers and pens. Notes banane ke liye ready ho jaiye. Bahut, bahut important, full of extra information class. Let's start Kingdom Monera. And immediately after the class, we'll do a mentee. Ready? Chalo, let's start. So, acha, aaj ek aur bahut important cheez hai. I have written something for you. I usually write poetry or write stories or articles whenever I have time, but I have written something for you called Winners Never Give Up. So something came to my mind, I wanted to talk to you about it. So I'm going to be telling you what that something special is. It's not a motivation talk, it's nothing, it's just a very heart-to-heart conversation which I'm going to be having with you at 6:30 p.m. Subha se I'm already three classes le chuke. Have you all seen those classes? Morning, did you mark your NCRTs, bachcho? Have you seen the endocrine and neuroendocrine diseases? Right, plant organization ki class aap de chuke. And this is something special which is coming for you. This is the fourth class since morning, fifth aane wali hai, aur sixth ye hai with mentee quiz again, part 7, double fertilization, embryogenesis, which is the most important topic of sexual reproduction, flowering plants. Ek bhi bachcha wo wali class miss nahi करेगा, not even a single child. चलिए, तो ये हमारा schedule था आज का. I hope आप ये तीनों classes लगा चुके हैं. This is the fourth class since morning, और दो और classes बची हुई हैं. This is very special because this Vani ma'am has written for we Biotonians. Winners never give up. Yes, चलिए. Telegram group I hope आप join कर चुके हैं. Daily का एक poll जो हम आपके लिए run कर रहे हैं. I hope you are answering and let's see who's the, you know, who answers best. Winners कौन होते हैं? तो ये हमारा, this is my aim, and I always talk very emotionally about the aim. My aim is ki we Biotonians ki aise national newspapers pe photo chape, because all we Biotonians deserve to succeed, deserve to do well in whatever they choose to do. App download kar lijiyega, channel ko like, share, subscribe zarur kar lijiyega for all this. Right? What does KVPY talk about it? It's Kishore Vigyanik Protsahan Yojana, jisme last year ka batch which I was taking has got selections. Make sure you like, share, subscribe to our amazing channel. VDNT.in/YT Live, our entire platform is free. Do join us for regular classes. Medji.com, we will play after the class. We will have a super amazing round of quiz where we are going to check your knowledge. Right now, I'm going to focus on Kingdom Monera. Starting the class. What is Monera? काफी कुछ तो आपको पता ही है, इसीलिए आप कह रहे थे कि मैम हम lichens में Monera कैसे देखेंगे? Yes. तो finally कल हमने बहुत सारी classifications पढ़ी और आखिर तक बच्चे full confused हो चुके थे. And they were like, ma'am, एक और classification, yes. तो उसके बाद उस classification के हिसाब से what we read in yesterday's class, you must go back home and see the RH Whittaker classification. The first and the most basic type, which is unicellular, जिसके पास nucleus भी नहीं है, is bacteria and monera. I'm going to give you a lot of detailed extra information, which I'm going to write here. So stay tuned and keep copying. They are unicellular organisms. They have a single cell. Cell wall is made up of peptidoglycans. The peptidoglycans, which is present in most of the bacteria, is N-acetyl. Write it down, please. N-acetyl. Can you see it? Yes, you can. Muramic acid. N-acetylmuriatic acid, which we call as NAM, and N-acetylglucosamine, NAG and NAM. Now, what you should know, because bacteria can really, you know, create or cause infections in human beings, so the human saliva, the human tears, the human mucus, the human secretions have something which is called as lysozyme. How am I teaching you? I'm teaching you two things which are interconnected with each other, which can give you an MCQ mark. So the saliva contains lysozyme, and this lysozyme can destroy the NAG-NAM, therefore destroying the bacteria or making it a cell wall deficient form. So next time somebody asks you, how do the bacteria, or what is there in the bacteria which is bactericidal, or what is there in the saliva which destroys the bacteria, you should say lysozyme, because lysozyme can destroy the cell wall. Create, done. Oh, no worries, Shikha. Done, everybody. So, their cell walls are made up of peptidoglycans. Yahi cheez plants mein hoti hai. Plant cell wall is made up of cellulose, hemicellulose and pectin. Aur yahi cheez hoti hai aapke fungus mein bhi. Cell walls. But there the cell wall is made up of chitin. Right? Point number two. Prokaryotic organization. Now, this is very important. This word, and I will write a couple of words here. They have a nucleus, but the nucleus is called a naked. They in fact don't have a nucleus. What I mean by having a nucleus is that they have a cell with just DNA like this. DNA is not packed inside a nucleus. Did you understand? We will have a quiz. So DNA is not packed. Correct? Very good, Jaswal. So their nucleus is just this. They don't really have a nucleus because it's not packed. So there, it's called the naked DNA, because write down all these extra points which I'm telling you, because there is no histone protein. So I'm writing minus histone. There are no histone proteins. First point, it is the oldest living organism with a DNA. It's called the incipient, really old, incipient DNA. It's called the genophore. The genophore, all these words come in MCQs. It is also referred to as fibrillar DNA because it is like a fiber. It is also referred to as fibrillar. Can you read 1, 2, 3, 4? I want you to copy down in your copies and don't be late. So you know it is naked because there are no histone proteins. It is not bound by a nuclear membrane. Right? They don't have an endoplasmic reticulum, they don't have a Golgi apparatus, they don't have lysosomes, and they don't have mitochondria. Because they don't have mitochondria, inka jo cell hota hai, usme surface area badhane ke liye, they have like this, you know, folds. In folds ko hum mesosomes ya mesosomes kehte hain. And these mesosomes do respiration for you. Please write it down. They only contain a 70S ribosome. The value S stands for Swedberg coefficient. Right? It's the unit of sedimentation. Correct? So, mitochondria ka analogous structure kaun hai? Mesosomes, which will increase the surface area and increase your respiration. So, this is the basic of Monera, which have bacteria. I have a question for you. Monera can also be classified into two types. You have the archaea bacteria, which are the oldest bacteria which live in the bottom of the ocean. Right? Or you can have eubacteria. The word eu stands for true. You also would have heard of something called rickettsia, actinomycetes. They're also part of the bacteria. Name. Now, this is open to you. We have 590 students watching. Let me see who answers it first. Name. And I'm going back to the slide there because I want to see who answers. Name the smallest Monera. Chaliye. Name the smallest Monera for me. Let me see who answers it first. Smallest Monera? Yes, Sony, smallest? No, Shadow. No, no, no. Bacteria specifically. Bacteria. Mycoplasma ke ilawa methanogens. Mycoplasma, PPLO. What else? What else? One more. Nobody in this entire class has been able to answer that for me. Mycoplasma is pleuro pneumonia like organism. It's not a true bacteria. No. Euglena, no. Methanogens, no. My God. Not even one child out of 630. Pleuro pneumonia like organism, no. That's the smallest living organ. I want a proper bacteria which has got bacteria like properties. It's a pleuro pneumonia like organism. It's not a real bacteria. My God, not even one person in the entire class. It's an AIIMS 2018 question. It's called Dynister pneumosynthes. I'm going to write it here. You can see it, yes. Write this down. You will open your textbooks and you will get this answer. Dynister pneumosynthes. Suna aapne? Dialister. Correct? Chali. So this was about the opening slide and you can see the extra information that we've been covering. Very important for 2020 also to attend all these classes. Characteristics of monera. They multiply by binary fission where one of them divides into two. I told you, you will have the bacteria which are the real bacteria. That's why I will also call them eubacteria because they are the real or the true ones. Archaea means the oldest. They can be methano, Phyllus, Methylotropus, the ones which produce methane. They can be ruminococcus, the ones which are present in the digestive system of the cow to produce methane. They reproduce by binary fission. Now, very important thing come to flagella. When I will do the cell with you, that time I will tell you what is 9 plus 0 microtubular arrangement. I will do centrioles with you. I will also tell you what is 9 plus 2 microtubular, 9 plus 0. That is not what we are doing now. But in locomotion, they have locomotive ability because of flagella, which has whip-like motion. There is something extra which I want to tell you with respect to flagella. What is that extra which I want to tell you? Agar ek bacteria ke charon taraf flagella lagao, to usko kya kehte hain? Peritrichus. Agar kisi ke ek hi taraf flagella lagao, to usko kya kahenge? Monotrichus. Agar kisi ke dono kono pe lagao, chalo, isko kya kahenge? Dono kono pe lagao. Dono kono pe. Amphi, I've always told you, amphi means both. अगर एक कोने पे ऐसे पूरा बंडल की तरह लगाओ, चलो बताओ एक कोने पे ऐसे बंडल की तरह लगाओ. सेफालो, सेफालो हेड बन गया ना, हेड सेफालिक, राइट. और अगर दोनों पे ऐसे टफ्ट्स हो, एक नहीं मेनी ऑफ देम, टफ्ट्स, लोफो, लोफो ट्राइकस. ट्राइका इज हेयर लाइक अटैचमेंट. सबके पीछे ट्राइकस जरूर लिख दीजिएगा, ट्राइकस. And if they don't have, if it doesn't have, then what will you call it? What will you call it? Atrichus. What are you going to call it? Atrichus. So I hope this is clear. All around peritrichus, single one monotrichus, both the sides single one amphitrichus, tuft on one side cephalotrichus, tuft on both the sides lophotrichus, no flagella, it is atrichus. The flagella is made up of the basal body, the hook and the flagella. What is the flagella made up of? We will do this when we talk about cell. It's made up of the basal body, the hook and the main product called the flagella. Flagella is made up of proteins called the flagellin. So flagellin proteins form the flagella. Is that clear, everybody in my class? We will give you PDF of every class, my dear children, on the Telegram group within 24 hours. We share the PDF of all the classes. Right. So that's called your flagellin protein. You also have pili for attachment. We will talk about that. Right. But in due course of time, dhire dhire, let's talk about each one of them. Chali. Let's move on to the mode of nutrition. Bacteria can be autotrophic. For example, blue-green algae. They can be parasitic, heterotrophic, saprotrophic. Autotrophic, do tarah ke hote hain. You can have chemoautotrophs or you can have photoautotrophs. Chemoautotrophs wo honge jo water will, they will not use water. For hydrogen, they might use hydrogen sulfide and convert this into sulfates. Are you understanding? Autotroph wo hote hain, they make their own food. So for making their own food, they require hydrogen. Now this hydrogen can come from water. If the hydrogen comes from water, by breaking water, we call it photoautotrophs. Photo means light, auto means self. So they break the water, they get the H and they produce oxygen. Whereas chemo is not going to use light, it's going to use a chemical like hydrogen sulfide. And once it is reduced, you will get sulfates. Saprophytic are the ones which depend on dead decaying organisms. Oldest archaeology is the study of fossils. Mujhe yaad hai bahut pehle when I saw the movie Dinosaurs wali movie Jurassic Park, I was very intrigued by, you know, archaeologists, especially mummy returns also. Cryptology or cryptography is usually the science of study of ancient symbols. People who do, you know, archaeology, they also have, like there's a language in India called Pali. Have you heard of the Pali language? So especially all the symbols which were written in the mummy returns in that mummy movie, they basically are cryptologist, cryptography, crypt is hidden. So archaea word is taken from archaeology, which means old. Correct everybody? Archaea word is taken from archaeology, which is old. And we have eubacteria, which are the real bacteria. Cyanobacteria, which is a blue-green algae, which is a misnomer. What is a misnomer? It's a wrong word. Please remember this, my dear, 2020, 2021 or 2021, ko to aata hoga. Cyanobacteria is not an algae, it's a bacteria. Anabina, rhizobium, nostoc, they are bacterias. Inko galti se pehle algae bol diya tha because they were doing photosynthesis. But ye plants nahi hai, ye bacteria hai. Mycoplasmas, rickettsias and actinomycetes. Actinomycetes pata hai ugde kaise hai? Actinomycetes, you know how, and they cause a really painful disease of the jaw. I remember we had once had a patient with actinomycetes, angular swelling itna swelling mein ho jata hai aur usme se pus nikalti hai. Jab aap actinomycetes ki pus nikalte ho aur usko agar aap you know on the cover slip dalenge and on the glass plate dalkar, once you will stain it and you will see it under the microscope, to actinomycetes ka arrangement is like this. The bacteria, so it looks like rays of the sun, right? So that is iska naam pad gaya tha, ray fungus. It looks like rays of the sun, actinomycetes. So ye sare bacteria hai, mycoplasmas, rickettsias, actinomycetes, inki diseases, what all do they do? We will all do that in due course of time. So abhi tak we have done this. Let me also tell you a little bit more about the shapes of the bacteria. If you have a bacteria which is round in shape, obviously you will call it coccus. Now there are two main things which you need to remember in coccus. The coccus, yeah, you can see this everybody, yes you can. Is that clear? Okay, am I too fast? Oh, I didn't realize that. I thought maybe everybody is understanding. Abhi theek hai, thoda slowly bol lete hain. Never mind, maybe thodi der mein you will get used to my speed. Theek hai, samajh mein aa raha hai, make hearts so that I can see it. Samajh aa gaya? Yes. Okay, we'll speak slowly. Done? Make hearts, menti hoga in the end of the class, bachcho. Once you finish the syllabus, we will do menti. Done? Chale aage? Done, 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 make hearts, perfect. Chalo. So we are, I'm going to be telling you a little bit extra about the shapes of the bacteria. A little bit extra about the shapes of the bacteria. Oh, aap log chote ho na, abhi 10th se aaye ho. Oh, I didn't realize that you kids are little used to speaking slowly. Right, we'll do that. 2022 wale bachche honge na. Was that too fast? Oh, I didn't realize that. We'll be slowly now. Da, is it clear? Right, and jo bachche ne late join kiya hai, please make sure that aap log hamari ek baar recording dekh lijiye. Chaliye. So shapes. Number one, if it's round in shape, I'm going to call it coccus. Right? It can be in the form of chains. Agar ye chain ki tarah dekho, I'm going to call it streptococcus. Correct? That is why, see, we are going very, very slow and deliberate. We are trying to explain every point to you. So ye hamara hoga streptococcus. पर अगर हम चेन नहीं बनाते हैं, we form clusters like grapes. देखिए, we form clusters like grapes. हम इसको कह देंगे staphylococcus. Correct? चलिए, और आगे बढ़ते हैं. You can also have bacteria. So coccus was number one. You can also have bacteria which are rod shaped. अगर आपके पास rod shaped bacteria है, for example, Bacillus subtilis. आज की क्लास में तो आई एम जस्ट गोइंग टू बी टेलिंग यू डिफरेंट टाइप्स, बाद में यू नो व्हेन आई विल टेल यू इन डिटेल ये क्या क्या डिजीज कॉज करते हैं, एवरीथिंग आई विल टेल यू, देन आई एम गोना कॉल इट बैसिलस, राइट? सो कोकस हमने कर लिया, उसके बाद हम बैसिलस में आएंगे, सिगार शेप्ड, राइट? डिप्लो बैसिलस, ट्रेप्टो बैसिलस, हो सकते हैं ये चेन में लगे हो, डिप्लो बैसिलस, ट्रेप्टो बैसिलस. एक और बड़ा इंपॉर्टेंट टाइप का है उसको भी करते हैं. देर आर सर्टन बैक्टीरिया विच आर इन द फॉर्म ऑफ स्पाइरल, इस पे बहुत एमसीक्यूज आते हैं. सो दे आर इन द फॉर्म ऑफ स्पाइरल शेप. स्पाइरल शेप बैक्टीरिया आर नोन एज स्पायरोकीट्स. नाम में देखो पता चल रहा है स्पायरोकीट्स. इसका एग्जाम्पल एग्जाम में बहुत आता है. लेट मी पुट अ स्टार मार्क. स्ट्रेप्टोकोकस आ सकता है, स्टिफाइलोकोकस आ सकता है, बट इसको आने के आई एम पुटिंग 3 stars. वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. दिस एग्जाम्पल इज कॉल्ड एज ट्रेपोनेमा. इसको थोड़ा मिटा देते हैं. ट्रेपोनेमा पैलेडियम. दिस इज ट्रिकी. तो आप 2 या 3 बार पढ़ोगे देन यू विल रिमेम्बर. ट्रेपोनेमा पैलेडियम, इट कॉजेज अ डिजीज विच वी नो एज सिफिलिस. सो क्वेश्चन में आता है सिफिलिस के बैक्टीरिया की शेप क्या है. यू विल हैव टू राइट स्पाइरल शेप. नेम अ स्पाइरोकीट. विच डिजीज इज कॉज बाय स्पाइरोकीट. एवरी वर्ड इज इंपॉर्टेंट. वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. स्पाइरल बैक्टीरिया सिफिलिस. नेम अ स्पाइरोकीट सिफिलिस. नेम द बैक्टीरिया विच कॉज सिफिलिस. ट्रेपोनेमा पैलेडियम. वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. Right, where is the like button? Oh, thank you so much, Farha. The like button is down. पर ये वी बायोटोनियंस के पुराने बच्चे तो महाकंजूस है. मुझे लग रहा है नए बच्चे भी कंजूस हो गए. Guys, can you make one like, one share, one subscribe for Vani ma'am? चलिए spiral, right everybody? Then there can be some bacteria which are in the shape of comma. So we've done third, let's do one more. There's one bacteria which can be in the shape of comma. This is called as vibrio. Comma shaped. Comma shaped vibrio is nothing but your vibrio cholera, which causes cholera. Right, everybody? Now they can be stalked, but that's not important. The 4 shapes are the most important. So this was a handmade mind map for the shapes of bacteria. Please copy this down. You know the maximum stars are here. The second most important is the grape-shaped clusters, which is this. Correct? Erasing it, you can go back home and see it again. Now this is it, but this is a photograph. So I specially made charts and showed you with my own handmade mind maps. Right? So cocci, ek single coccus hoga, micrococcus, 2 honge, diplococcus. They are always in pairs. Diplococci usually cause pneumonia. Likh lijiye extra information. Likhiye main side ho rahi hu. So that you can take a snapshot if you want. Diplococcus kya cause karta hai bachcho? Diplococci pneumonia. So diplococci, where there are 2 of them together, see? 2 of them, it can cause pneumonia. Important. Streptococci will be in chain. Grape-like clusters will be staphylococcus. Rod-shaped with or without flagella. Did I explain all the types of flagella to you? What is Lophotrichus, Amphitrichus, Peritrichus? Did I explain atrichus, right? So you can have diplobacilli, you can have streptobacilli, they're in chains, right? I told you bacillus subtilis, right? Vibrio is the comma shaped. That's why we call it comma shaped here. See, they're usually motile, they are going to cause vibrio cholera, V cholera. Vibrio cholera and spiral shape. हो सकता है एक कोने में flagella हो. मैंने आपको extra information दे दी. They are spirochetes. Example is Treponema pallidum. Did you understand? Thank you, Omi, Meena, Jasmeet. Diplococci was also used in a very famous experiment called the Frederick Griffith experiment, which we will do in genetics. Diplococci के पास एक capsule होती है. There is one capsule. Inside one capsule, you have 2 of them together. It usually causes pneumonia. Done, everybody? Chale? Perfect. Mentee is coming. So these are very important. Bacteria, मैं आपको पूरा अच्छे से याद करवा दूंगी. Let's come to archaea bacteria. In subsequent lectures, I will also talk about Gram staining. There was a scientist who's known as the name of Hans Christian Gram. कैसे Mr. Gram ने अलग अलग तरह से bacteria को classify किया. The ones who became purple, पहले उन्होंने उनको जैसे archaea bacteria classification है, वैसे Gram staining में purple bacteria और pink color से stain होने वाले bacteria को separately classify किया. He said the ones which are purple, he called them Gram positive. The ones, मैं आपको plasmid के बारे में भी बताऊंगी. The ones which are pink, he called them Gram negative. आपके मन में आएगा, why do we need to know so much? Because bacteria causes diseases. They are very dangerous. Gram positive की जो medicines होते हैं, drugs होते हैं, which are very different from the drugs or the medicines or the antibiotics we give for Gram negative. So let's begin with the classification and slowly, steadily, we will build up on the classification. The simplest and the most primitive. Primitive word means the oldest. Are your archaea bacteria? Is it? Yes. Nasreen, Alina, everybody, please pay attention in the class. Right, everybody? That's called your archaea bacteria. Ek cheez aapko bahut important bacteria ke baare mein pata honi chahiye. Bacteria have an ability to stay together. Right? Bacteria really stay together in colonies. Right? ये बना लेते हैं कुछ which is known as colony. They really stay together. क्योंकि ये colony बनाते हैं, that is why they are able to attack together. Correct? And because they are able to attack together, that is the reason why they cause so many diseases. They stick together on a surface. Can anybody in the class tell me how do they stay together? What is the property of bacteria which allows them to stay together? Anybody? Please tell me. Right? Colonies, colonial. Yes. What is it? Sanram, are you understanding? Very good, guys. I'm speaking slowly only. Yes. Ab main aise nahi bol sakti. Simplest and most primitive group of bacteria. So jaoge aap log? Yes, 11th में आ गए, थोड़ा सा तेज बोलना पड़ेगा ना. अब मैं भी slowly, slowly करूँ. Primitive group of bacteria, cell wall, polysaccharide and proteins, peptidoglycan. अब ऐसे बोलोगे सो जाए, आपने सुनोगे मैं भी सुनोगी. Yes or no? है ना? चलिए तो ऐसे तो नहीं बोल सकते ना बच्चों. चलो but I will try. See, I'm going slowly. कम slides करा रही हूँ, दिन में आपको सब कुछ समझा रहे हैं. Can't go so slow, right, everybody? So they stay together because they have something. क्यों रह रहे थे एक साथ? They have something which is called as glycocalyx. Write it down. They have something which is called as glycocalyx. It is the capsule which is very, very sticky. So they stay together. इसका एक और नाम होता है glycocalyx का. Anybody who can tell me? चलिए स्माइल बनाना बंद कीजिए. इसका एक और नाम बताइए, इसका एक और नाम बताइए. ग्लाइकोकैलिक्स और कैप्सूल्स बिकॉज ऑफ व्हिच दे स्टे टुगेदर. टेल मी वन मोर नेम. किसी ने नहीं दिया अभी तक. वेरी गुड ऋतिक एंड जसमीत सिंह सेठी, वेरी गुड. इट्स कॉल्ड द स्लाइम लेयर. लिखिए चिपचिपा, चिपचिपी लेयर. इट्स कॉल्ड द स्लाइम लेयर. स्लाइम लेयर 100% एमसीक्यू क्वेश्चन. ग्लाइकोकैलिक्स 100% एमसीक्यू क्वेश्चन. इट इज अ कैप्सूल व्हिच हेल्प्स देम स्टे टुगेदर बिकॉज ऑफ व्हिच दे अटैक. दे फॉर्म अ आर्मी ऑफ बैक्टीरिया एंड दे अटैक. सो द आउटरमोस्ट लेयर ऑफ बैक्टीरिया इज द स्लाइम लेयर. इट इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड द ग्लाइकोकैलिक्स. इट इज द कवरिंग और द कैप्सूल. इसकी वजह से बैक्टीरिया स्टे टुगेदर फॉर्मिंग अ कॉलोनी बिकॉज ऑफ व्हिच दे अटैक. सो इट गिव्स इम्यूनोजेनिक पावर. राइट इट डाउन. बिकॉज ऑफ विच दे गेट इम्यूनोजेनिक. हिमांशु गौतम एब्सोल्युटली राइट. मैंने मॉक का एग्जाम्पल दिया हुआ है. दे गेट इम्यूनोलॉजिकल पावर. दे गेट इम्यूनिटी. दे गेट स्ट्रेंथ. चलिए सेल वॉल. व्हाट डिड आई टेल यू दिस पॉलीसैकेराइड्स वर. इनके नाम बताइए जो मैंने अभी आपको थोड़ी देर पहले बताया. चलो 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 चलो. आयुष, दिव्या, आयुष, वरलक्ष्मी, पूर्वा, इसका नाम बताइए मुझे. पॉलीसैकेराइड्स के नाम बताइए. Oh, cherry, it's not so great. Nag-nam. Nag-nam. Remember that. Right? So it's made up of nag and nam. And who kills the nag-nam? Who destroys the nag-nam? Bataye. NCERT se bata rahi hu sare questions. Nag-nam ko kaun marega? Who will destroy the nag-nam? Koi to batao. Nag-nam ko kaun penicillin marega? Aur lysozyme. Maine aapko kya bola? Lysozyme which will come in exams. Right? And proteins. peptidoglycans and muromic acid are, they will have N-acetyl muromic acid and N-acetyl ones. Cell membrane is made up of monolayer of branched chain lipid. Right? Now, archaea bacteria mein muromic acid wagaira nahi hoga. It will be present in the real bacteria. The U bacteria, dekhi. Real bacteria mein hoga. Real bacteria, the U bacteria. Cell membrane mein ek single layer hoti hai lipids ki. Usually, हमारे सेल में कितनी लेयर्स होती है लिपिड्स की बताइए. कितनी लेयर्स होती है हमारे हमारी बॉडी में कितनी लेयर्स होती है तनवीर जी लिपिड्स आ रहा है. वी हैव टू लेयर्स बट दे हैव अ सिंगल लेयर. आपकी बैक्टीरिया आर कंसिडर्ड टू बी द ओल्डेस्ट ऑफ लिविंग फॉसिल्स. दे कैन लिव इन रियली डीप ओशंस. जब ये बहुत डीप ओशंस में रहते हैं देयर इज अ स्पेशल आर्की बैक्टीरिया विच यू शुड नो अबाउट जिसका नाम है थर्मस एक्वेटिकस. Which can live in deep thermal vents, जहां से गर्म पानी निकलकर मिट्टी से आता है. So they live in their thermophiles. What is thermophiles? Now I will tell you this. I hope you are copying every word down. They are thermophiles. That means they can live in really hot conditions. They are acidophiles. They can live in file is to love. They can live in really file is to love. They can live in acidic temperatures. Right, everybody? So they are thermophiles. They are acidophiles. One more file. Can anybody tell me one more file of these bacteria? Halophiles. They can live in really high salt condition. Right? They can live in high amount of methane, which is very toxic. Human beings can't live here. Methanophiles. So all these words should be at the tip of your tongue. You get my point? They are thermophiles, live in high temperatures. They can live in acidic conditions. They can live in high salt conditions. They can live in methanogen condition, the rumen of the cattle. Very good batch. So all these words should be at the tip of your tongue. Extreme habitats. Methanogens are present in the guts of several ruminants. Ruminants are those organisms like cows, omasum, abomasum, rumen. They have multiple stomachs, right? They produce methane. Halophiles live in salt lakes, dead sea. Thermophiles, hot springs. Manikaran is a hot spring in India. Have you all heard of Manikaran? There's a gurudwara in Manikaran called the Manikaran Sahib, where the sulfur rich water is there. There are very, very high amount of sulfur salts which are there. It's very hot water. They are methanogens which are found in marshy areas, bogs, marshes, right? So thermoacidophiles live in these areas. Is that clear? They have very strong antiseptic properties. Omasum, abomasum, rumen, right? The stomachs of the cow. Chaliye. U bacteria pe aate hain. U bacteria are your real bacteria, are your true bacteria, right? U ka matlab hota hai real, true. Is that clear? Done, everybody? Chalo. Aage bade. Correct? Okay? Chalo. Any doubts? Chale. Any doubts? Understanding? Aapki bacteria pe clarity mil gayi. शेप साइज पे क्लैरिटी मिल गई, आउटर कवरेज पे क्लैरिटी मिल गई, फ्लैजेला पे क्लैरिटी मिल गई. अब आगे बढ़ते हैं, लेट्स कम ऑन टू द यू बैक्टीरिया. आई विल आल्सो डू द बैक्टीरियल डिजीजेस एंड थिंग्स लाइक दैट. आई एम वेरी एक्साइटेड बिकॉज़ क्विज इज कमिंग एंड आई ट्राई टू मेक द क्विज टफ. सो लेट्स सी हाउ मेनी ऑफ यू डू वेल इन द क्विज. डन. लाइक कौन करेगा, शेयर कौन करेगा और सब्सक्राइब कौन करेगा लेक्चर को बता दीजिए. हु इज द वन हु इज गोइंग टू बी मैस्कॉट ऑफ वी बायोटोनिक? यस, हु इज द वन हु इज गोइंग टू लाइक शेयर सब्सक्राइब. चलो आगे बढ़ते हैं और रियल बैक्टीरिया पे आ जाते हैं. Also known as the true bacteria, the cell wall is rigid and made up of peptidoglycans. Nag-nag ki cell wall bani hui hai. It moves with the help of flagella. Ye autotrophs ho sakte hain. Autotrophs ho sakte hain, maine aapko pehle hi bata diya. Autotrophs can be photo or chemo. Purple sulfur bacteria, green sulfur bacteria, jinke paas pigments hoga, bacteria, viridian bacteria, right? Jo purple sulfur color ke hoge, ya photosynthetic jo photolysis or water. Cyanobacteria, blue green algae is unicellular, single cell hota hai, colonies banata hai, filamentous, it can form, see filaments like this, marine, land mein reh sakta hai. One very important property of cyanobacteria is, it fixes atmospheric nitrogen in cells. The most, that is why a plant hota hai, us plant ka naam hota hai, cycas. Write this down, very important extra information. एक प्लांट होता है उसका नाम होता है साइकस. साइकस की जो रूट्स होती हैं, उनकी रूट्स में साइनोबैक्टीरिया रहता है. सो साइनोबैक्टीरिया लिव्स इन द रूट्स ऑफ द साइकस प्लांट एंड इट इज कॉल्ड एज द कोलोरॉइड रूट्स. लिख रही हूं मैं यहां, प्लीज कॉपी दिस, कोलोरॉइड रूट्स. राइट, स्ट्रेट लिख देते हैं अगर आपको इसे पढ़ा नहीं जा रहा है. कोलोरॉइड रूट्स, बिकॉज ये रूट्स में या जहां पर भी रहे, दिस bacteria has the ability to fix nitrogen, right? Why does it fix nitrogen, everybody? Can you tell me? क्यों fix करता है nitrogen? Yes, Sethi, इसको वो कहते हैं, correct? क्यों fix करता है ये? इसीलिए fix करता है, because it is going, this is a macronutrient. सबसे इंपॉर्टेंट न्यूट्रिएंट होता है ये मैक्रोन्यूट्रिएंट. प्लांट्स को बहुत ज्यादा चाहिए होता है बिकॉज डीएनए बनाता है नाइट्रोजन. मैक्रोन्यूट्रिएंट्स आपके पास तीन होते हैं, नाइट्रोजन, फास्फोरस, पोटेशियम. वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट, अगेन प्लीज कॉपी दिस. आपके पास तीन मैक्रोन्यूट्रिएंट्स होते हैं. सो ये जो तीनों मैक्रोन्यूट्रिएंट्स है बहुत ज्यादा चाहिए होते हैं. दैट्स व्हाई साइनोबैक्टीरिया इज वेरी गुड बिकॉज इट इंक्रीजेस द फर्टिलिटी ऑफ द सॉइल. एग्जाम्पल नॉस्टॉक, एनाबीना. Right? These are your cyanobacteria. Is that clear? तो इनके बाहर ये mucilage की covering होती है, जो मैंने अभी आपको बोला, आपने मुझे बताया, ये stick करने में help करेगी. And heterocyst is the area where the nitrogen fixation takes place. This is a very important MCQ question. The point where the nitrogen fixation by the cyanobacteria takes place is known as heterocyst, and they have a mucilaginous slime layer around it, jiski wajah se they can colonize, they can remain in colonies. Very, very important points about cyanobacteria. Blue-green algae, cyanobacteria, nitrogen fixation, every year one question will come. Right? Mode of nutrition pe aate hain. What are the various modes of nutrition of cyanobacteria? Cool, everybody, are you all able to understand? Oxidize. Now see, first mode of nutrition will be autotrophs, and that also will be photoautotrophs in the ones who have blue-green algae. They will break the light. Light will come and they will do photolysis of water and can be oxygenic. Some of them can be anoxygenic. That means they do not produce oxygen. Right, everybody? Right, PDF bachcho mil jayega. Some of them can be anoxygenic. Right? Anoxygenic are the ones jo inorganic substances ko use karenge. Aur jab wo inorganic substances ko use karenge, they are not going to produce any amount of oxygen. Is that clear, everybody? अब आपको ये एक बहुत important extra point बता रही हूँ, please write it down. जितने भी bacteria के पास pigment होगा, chloroplast is not present in bacteria. ये bacteria it will not have organelles. तो इसके पास ऐसा कोई grana thylakoid नहीं होगा. अगर आपने अभी 9th-10th में कभी पढ़ा है, nope. It will not have. So pigments कहाँ होंगे? Can anybody tell me where will the pigments be? अगर वो autotrophic है, photoautotrophic है या कैसे भी है, where are the pigments going to be? So the pigments are going to be in the membrane. And these membrane pigments are called as chromatophores. Very important from MCQ point of view. It's going to be in the membrane. It's called as chromatophores. Is that clear? जैसे आपका purple sulfur bacteria, उसके पास bacterial chlorophyll होगा. It will have bacterial chlorophyll. Right? और ये ATP produce करेंगे. Correct, everybody? They also play a great role in recycling nutrients like nitrogen, phosphorus, iron and sulfur. So nitrosomonas ये आपके chemoautotrophs हैं. Nitrococcus, Bigetua, Theobacillus and Theotens. Very, very important. Theoxidants, Theobacillus, Bigetua, Nitrococcus, Nitrosomonas. Heterotrophic वो होंगे, which bacteria will depend on somebody else for their food, include decomposers. So many bacteria help in decomposition. Depend on ready-made organic nutrients. E. coli भी आपका एक decomposing material ही है. Right? So, आपको मैंने बताया, autotrophic के दो types बताया. I told you chemoautotrophs, I told you photoautotrophs. Chemoautotrophs, purple sulfur bacteria. Right? They are going to reduce H2S, H ले लेंगे and convert it into sulfates. Is that clear? So this was just the beginning of Monera. We tried to tell you the basics of Monera, which we are going to be continuing in the next class. Now, if you look carefully, we've done living taxonomy, taxonomical aids, quizzes kar chuke hain. Kal ki class mein humne aapko five kingdom classification karaya aur aaj Monera. So can we do the MCQs please? And yahi class abhi hum continue karte rahenge. To aap log jo menti kar rahe ho, menti ko le aaye. Are you ready? Anatomy of Flowering Plants. I hope aap log dekh chuke ho. And guys, one like, share, subscribe for Pani Ma'am. Come on my screens. My 2022 Dear Bachcha Party began. And kal se ma'am will speak slowly. Done? Because ma'am ko thodi aadat dalni padegi 2022 jaise. Chunnu munnu batch hai na? So uske saath bolne ki thodi si aadat dalni padegi. Like, share, subscribe kar dijiyega zaroor. Aur ab hum move karte hain. Menti, jisne kiya hua hai mere pyare bachcho ko senti. चलिए कोड है, मैं कोड लिख देती हूँ आप लोगों के लिए. आपको menti.com पे जाना है. आई विल टेल यू हाउ टू डू इट. सो यू हैव टू गो टू menti.com. आ गए बच्चे. 141521 हमारा कोड है. आई नो इट इज नॉट विजिबल, दिख रहा है आज. ओहो, कुछ तो हो गया है मेरी स्क्रीन को. मैं कल ठीक करती हूँ इसको. 141521. आई एम राइटिंग द कोड हियर आल्सो. बच्चों, पुराने बच्चों, एक बार कोड लिख दो. एक बार कोड लिख दीजिए. नसरीन, टेलीग्राम ग्रुप कैसे ज्वाइन करना है आपको? आपने एक टेलीग्राम की ऐप होती है, उसको डाउनलोड करना है. टेलीग्राम की ऐप आपने डाउनलोड जब कर ली, जब आपने एक बार टेलीग्राम की ऐप डाउनलोड कर ली, तो उसमें आपने वेदांत अंडरस्कोर बायोटॉनिक सर्च करना है. थैंक यू सायरा. सायरा ने लिखा है, सारे बच्चे एक बार लिख दीजिए कोड. रोहिणी ने लिख दिया, गौरी ने लिख दिया, नए बच्चों के लिए. ओल्ड बच्चों, थोड़ी सी रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी ले लो चैनल में. 141521 आपने ऐसे कर दिया, उसके बाद आपने सबमिट कर दिया. तो सी, आई एम द स्नो मैन, माय नेम इज फ्रॉस्टी, लवली, एंड आई एम रेडी टू प्ले द क्विज विद यू. हाउ स्वीट एंड फ्रॉस्टी. यस, मेरा गला खराब है तो उसने कहा चलो मैं आपको फ्रॉस्टी बना देते हैं. यस, चलिए. आई नो चेरी भाई, तो मैं बोल रही हूँ मेरा गला खराब है, मुझे वो आइसक्रीम दिला के लालच दिखा रहा है. चल जल्दी जल्दी जल्दी. 141521. आई बीन टेकिंग, दिस इज द सेवेंथ क्लास इंक्लूडिंग द पेड लेक्चर सिंस मॉर्निंग. वी हैव 10 क्लासेस एवरी डे. उफ, हू इज दिस क्यूटी, हू इज दिस वुल्फ, ये कौन है, ये कौन है? शर्लॉक होम्स, कैटरपिलर बनी, फ्रेंडली घोस्ट, पॉटरजिस्ट, फोर लीफ क्लोवर, वॉल्केनो, लायन, सिम्बा. ये तो बेचारा, ये मारे घोस्ट बर्गर ट्रक, उस पुलिसमैन, द बबल बी, द ट्रेन. यस, चले स्टार्ट करें. Somebody's called Casper. You're also Frosty. चलो, starting in 5, 4. We're going to be starting quick. Come on guys, you should know we start the quiz. You should be ready with one more window of Menti open every day. That's the way to do it. No wastage of time. You see, we did not take even 1 second break. Jaise class shuru hui, we did not take any break. That's the way to do it. No talking, no break. Come on. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And start. Start the quiz. Question number 1 on your screens now. Oh, isse easy question nahi aa sakta. Conjugation is sexual reproduction. When the conditions are unfavorable, it forms a spore which is inside the bacteria called the endospore. Sexual reproduction is conjugation, which is very rare. So which is the most common method of reproduction in bacteria? It's a method where the bacteria divides into two. What is the method in which the bacteria divides into two? Dursuk, are you understanding? Dinakar, Nayan Pratap Singh, Sangeeta Gaikwad. Very good. Oh, this is called Namnebula. So it is nothing but binary fission or division into two. It can be binary fission. It can even be multiple fission. Endospores form when there is unfavorable condition. Conjugation is a sexual transmission which happens because of plasmids, HFR cells. Right, everybody, sex virus is getting formed. They are not common conditions. Very good. I'm very proud of you. Let's move on to the second question. Proud, very proud. What is the code, my dear? The code is 141521. Smrita Sharma, the code is 141521. Oops, looks like there was a mistake. There is no question. Probably Menti was hungry like me and it ate the question away. So can we move on to the next one? I don't know what you guys are answering. Probably Menti is goofed up. It happens sometimes. It's a software. It does technical issues. We really try and help them but cannot really do anything. So question number 3 on your screens, please. Oh, it happens sometimes. Don't worry. Menti must have been really hungry. Let's bear with Menti. Bacteria oxidize various inorganic substances such as nitrates, nitrites, and ammonia and use the released energy for ATP production. They play an important role in recycling of nutrients. Maine aapko nitrates ki jagah sulfate bataya tha. Exam mein exactly same bataya tha, sulfates. Kaun se bacteria hain? Aapko at least 2 or 3 times repeat karke bataya tha maine. I want good. Close to ma'am ne bola phototrophic nahi karenge, photo autotrophic, water ko todenge in the presence of sunlight, which is called as photolysis. So if they are using chemicals for photosynthetic, can I call it chemi osmotic or chemi autotrophic? Chemi word use kar sakti hu main? Chemi osmosis, chemicals ka movement, chemotaxis, chemical ki wajah se movement, can I call it chemo autotrophic? Photo autotrophic is because of sunlight. अब सनलाइट नहीं है, दे आर यूजिंग केमिकल्स टू कॉज मूवमेंट, कैन आई कॉल इट कीमो ऑटोट्रोफ? येस और नो? डिड आई टेल यू H2S पर्पल सल्फर बैक्टीरिया, बैक्टीरियोक्लोरोफिल? मैंने आपको कितनी बार इसका अभी बताया था. सो आई एम गोना कॉल इट कीमो ऑटोट्रोफ, विच इज ऑप्शन नंबर 2, नॉट फोटो ऑटोट्रोफ. यस, चलिए नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन ऑन स्क्रीन प्लीज. फोटोसिंथेटिक पिगमेंट्स इंक्लूड, what are the pigments? Are they chlorophyll A, carotenes, xanthophyll, or all of these? What are the photosynthetic pigments? Chlorophyll A, carotenoids. What are they? Remember, majority of the times that, or 60 to 65% of the time that all of these is the answer, all of these is usually the answer. I'm sure about chlorophyll A and carotenoids. Will the answer be all of these? Come on. Oops. It will be. Majority of the pigment is chlorophyll A, but there are certain amounts of carotenes and xanthophylls also. This is majority, let's say 92%. The rest is this. So answer will be all of these. Chlorophyll A, carotenes, xanthophylls. I repeat, chlorophyll A, carotenes, xanthophylls. Write down. All of these are supposed to be extra information packets for you. Chlorophyll A, carotenes, xanthophylls. Chlorophyll A, carotene, xanthophyll. Now I told you, I gave you an example of Cycas revoluta. Why will you use cyanobacteria in agricultural fields? I told you there is something which is a macronutrient which plants need. Do they need it for photosynthesis? Algal bloom is too much of growth of algae, or do they require it for nitrogen fixation? Bataiye. Why do they need it? Why do they need it for nitrogen fixation? I told you macronutrients. I gave you an example of Cycas revoluta. Very good, very good. It has to be. Guys, it's not the last one. No, 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 no. It has to be for fixation of nitrogen. It's a macronutrient. Plants require it. Is that clear? Yes, so plants will require it in the fields. Isliye seeds mein hum rhizobium vagaira ko coat karke dete hain. These seeds are also available in the market. Did you understand? So bacteria will increase the yield of the field. Striker Saloni for Abhi sir. Yay, I'll convey your message to Abhi. That means Abhishek sir, he's our class 10, super great teacher. Shreya, Shreya, Meghna, Roy, Soumya, Frozen King, Hannah, Iliocarpus, Genitrus, Sushant Sharma, Pradhaik Kadhi. Okay, nice, whatever. Yes, Shreya Saroni, happy for you. And come on everybody, well done, well done, well done. Proud of you. I'm going to be seeing some of you at 9 o'clock. I'm going to see all of you at 6:30 for a supercharged motivation session. And I'm going to see tomorrow morning all of you at 8. And my dear 2022 batch, you have to see me tomorrow evening again at 5 o'clock. Same time, same place till then. Take care. Revise the chapter. We meet again tomorrow. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe. That's all for the day. Go back home. Read your NCRTs. Make good notes. Ta-da! Tomorrow, 2022 batch, same time. The rest of you, 6:30 today. For a beautiful something that I've written for you, and 9 o'clock again today. Bye.